This was supposed to be easy. Just track her down again, bring her home. I had no idea how wrong I was, and how far I would really have to go.
Search for the missing girl continues in the deep ravines.
Please, tell me that she's safe.
Your hysterics aren't helping. Stop calling me.
Thank you. I really doing this? Moving so far away from civilization to be the man who will turn the tide of war when everything else fails. Millions of lives are at stake. And I have to save them, finish my work, break the code before it breaks me. Time is not on my side. Determination means everything now. For too long I've been misled, but the answer was there, right in front of me.
Ah! My name's Detective Reinhardt, Roswell Police Department. You're trespassing on an active crime scene. Give yourself up peacefully. No one has to get hurt here.
Last time, we showed you some of the ominous beginnings of Edward Pierce's adventure. Today, we're going to delve deeper along the path of madness.
Please, I don't want him to find me.
The early stages of the investigation already made it clear that this is no ordinary case. However, as Pierce continues his search for the terrible truth, he will be plunged to the brink of insanity, confronted with horrifying visions, zealous cultists, and perhaps even the old ones themselves.
But the earth will resound to your cries.
Many of the foes that Pierce encounters on Darkwater Island are beyond human comprehension, and offering up any physical fight will most likely be futile. Most of the time, you will need to rely on other skills such as speech, medicine, and knowledge of the occult, if only to delay the inevitability of crossing such cosmic horrors. Subterfuge is also an option. While escaping the gaze of the Great Dreamer is an impossibility, more mortal beings are not so all-seeing.
You are gifted indeed.
Bring me more sacred flesh
for your return into the kingdom of the earth.
Stealth will sometimes be the best way to evade a terrible fate, though this is made harder by Pierce's crippling fear of the dark and small spaces. Every grim vision and traumatic sight has the potential to reduce Pierce's sanity. Skirting the lines between sanity and madness is a certainty in Call of Cthulhu. As it lessens, Pierce's ability to draw logical conclusions will become less reliable, and his perception of reality will change. The Darkwater investigation will push Pierce beyond his physical and mental limits as he's drawn ever closer to the domain of the Great Dreamer.
I'm low.
You were in Mommy's tummy. Mommy's sister went to heaven. The church was filled with bright yellow lilies. And she looked at me and said she wanted to name you Lily.
Lily.
After the most beautiful flower she ever saw.
Lily. Lily. Lily.
Daddy, do you think I'm beautiful too?
Jack. No.